Hi, I'm Nina from Peslo's pre-sales team, and I'll be giving you a quick overview of our PRTG desktop client. First things first, I would like to mention that the desktop client is a full-featured management console for PRTG, so includes all the functions you're used to from our web interface, plus an additional feature, which is the integration of multiple cores. Let's start by adding an additional PRTG server to our desktop client. We can do this by navigating to File, Settings, and then clicking on the plus button up here. I have to enter my server. My login name. And my password, of course. So now we see we have two different cores here. One is my personal playground here, and the other one is our German PRTG demonstration. So let's start by exploring the interface of the desktop client. As you see, this is where we added the additional server. This is where I can now navigate between my two servers. And here I can change some settings. What you also see is the different tabs here, which are similar to the ones you already know from our web interface. So you'll have the device tree, the libraries, sensors, alarm, maps, reports, logs, and tickets. The only thing that's new in the desktop client is the tools. Up here, you also find a global search bar. And of course, you get your quick overview over the different sensor states. On the left, you'll always find your device tree as you're used to it from the web interface. And on the right, you'll get a little more additional details. And also you have quick action buttons. So if we drill down, we see this is exactly as it is in our web interface. We have our different probes. In my installation, this would be only one local probe. But if we navigate to the PRTG demo, we can see that there's our local probe and our different remote or two different remote probes. We always get the sunburst view in addition to some graphs. So one of the fun features of the desktop client is that when I select two sensors, for example, the ping and my volume total, I'm able to compare these two sensors, which is of course more useful if I would, for example, want to compare the state of our AWS instances. So I say the ping of my US instance and the ping of my German instance. So now I'm able to compare these sensors. And of course, this also works with more than two sensors if I add our island demo. So another fun thing you can do with the PRTG desktop client is you can move around groups. So for example, I can take my Google services and move it into my personal group. One thing you should keep in mind here, there is no undo or go back button. So changes you do here are permanent and sometimes hard and difficult to undo. So as mentioned at the beginning, one of the great advantages is that we now have the possibility to use the multi-core dashboard or details. So let's first jump into the dashboard. This will give us a quick overview over the two PRTG instances I have added, so my personal playground and my PRTG demo. I can switch between the overall sensor overview and the current alarms for these probes. But a feature I love is the multi-core details. So let's first get this window up and big. So now we would also have the overview over all of our different sensors. In this case, it's the errors and all the warnings and unusual. I can also filter this to just show me errors. But I can switch the view to the tabularic view. And now I can filter, which is great. I can filter by server, I can filter by probe, I could filter by group, by sensor name, sensor status. And now if we go into the sensor status and filter it by that, we'll see that I'll actually be able to see all my sensors for the two installation I have installed in the same place, which gives me a very condensed view over my PRTG. So this was a very quick overview over PRTG's desktop client. Should there be any remaining questions, feel free to contact us anytime at support@passler.com.
If you find this video helpful, feel free to like it and consider watching our other videos on our channel. If you still have questions, please contact support@passler.com, and always feel free to comment for feedback or suggestions for other topics. Thank you.